Good morning and welcome. I'm Saqib Shaikh. I'm a software engineer in the Artificial Intelligence and Research Group. I'm also blind. And on Stack Overflow, my highest voted answer is, how can you code if you can't see? So I thought, OK, I'm going to show you that today. The answer, of course, is using Visual Studio. And I also happen to use a screen reader, which runs in the background and narrates what is happening on the screen. So I thought, OK, I'm going to show you how I code a simple program in Visual Studio. So that's speaking really fast and in a robotic voice. That's how I code, because I want to be as efficient as possible. So this is the challenge. Can you understand what it says? Okay, so, you know, file, new project. Now what am I going to code? This is always a bit of a dilemma. So I thought, hello world is a bit boring. So let's do a talking hello world. So I need to add a reference to the speech library. So I'm going to add a reference. And let's add the using at the top. using system. And just like for anyone else, it's reading me out the IntelliSense, so I don't have to do all that typing. So let's continue with this epic program. And let's press F5 and see if it can build.
Hello world.
Yay! Now, I've been using Visual Studio since I was at high school and got it in the back of a book. And it's always been somewhat accessible. But there have always been these little challenges. You know, this little screen here or this little thing there is less than perfect. So a year ago, roughly, I got to sit down with the VS team, and I walked them through some of this. And I think they were, you know, they're stoked. They basically have renewed their accessibility efforts, which is so good news for someone like myself. And they've gone through systematically analyzing the user interface, identifying all the areas where there needed to be a few accessibility improvements. For example, making sure it works with high contrast, or that you can use it with the keyboard, or that the accessibility APIs are implemented. So they went through and they've done that. And we're starting to see the changes today, which is amazing for me. And I'm going to show you just some of those. Maybe the biggest pain point for me was using the debugger, like the locals window. It used to be not accessible, so I used to actually have to copy text out of the locals window into Notepad so that I could read what the variable value was. And that sucked. So let's make this program a bit bigger and then look at the debugging experience. So let's make this program so instead of saying hello world, it says whatever is on the command line. So. So there's nothing on the command line, we'll still say. It does capitals in a higher pitch. That's why it sounds all funny. And let's see if that still works. No. I don't have builder as normally.
Okay,
I know, we've got a new line in constant. Oh, there's a quote at the end. There you go, get rid of that. Yay!
Hello, world.
Yay, we're back in action. Okay, so now let's put a breakpoint here so we can try it with the command line arguments. So put a breakpoint there, run it again, and here we hit the breakpoint. So let's go into this debugger window, which was formerly inaccessible. And it's telling me args has length 0. Okay, that's what we expect. So let's just edit that. Edit value, and it's going to be a new string array. What should I say? So now I can even expand this, and it's treating it like a tree view, which it should, and it's, you know, I can go through all the elements of the array. And if we just continue.
Visual
Studio
rocks. Cool.
Cool. So this is just. With these things, often it's just the small changes which matter. For example, that locals window, one of the developers just went through and made sure that it implemented all the accessibility APIs. But it makes such a big difference to my productivity and the way that I code every day. So maybe if you work on any user interfaces, be they desktop, mobile, or web, then these small changes in your apps could make a real big difference to someone who uses your apps slightly differently. Thank you.